On this week's episode, we talk about some new Zelda rumors, Stardew Valley, and we hype up No Man's Sky. Welcome to Video Games, eh? Everyone, and welcome to Video Games, eh? The very Canadian podcast where we discuss some of the latest video game news, the games we've been playing recently, and other video game related stuff. My name is Garrett May, and with me, as always, is my co-host, Josh Taylor. How are you doing today, buddy?
I'm doing really well, Garrett. That's good. It's good to hear from you. It's been a while, like a week or something since we talked.
It's been about a week since we've done this.
Nice.
How was your week?
My week was good. I actually saw you on Saturday in real life.
I know, it was weird. I don't know if we should do it again.
Okay, I'm down. We'll just keep it to the podcast, then.
I'll think about it. Actually, starting now, we might not even be able to see each other on the podcast. I don't know. I'm still debating.
We are having some technical difficulties, but we've got the workaround. No one will know.
We'll let you know next week. Okay, you can now find Video Games A on iTunes, YouTube, and of course at yesguygaming.com, where you can also find plenty of video game reviews done by yours truly. So, however you're listening to this, like, check out our content, subscribe, all that great stuff. We greatly appreciate your support. All right, enough of that. Time to go for a rip, eh, bud? Let's start the show and get her going, bud.
you all
set for the show, Josh?
Oh, wait. Did you pick up news, or was that me?
I got the news today, bud.
Good, because I don't have any.
Hot off the press, eh? All right, number one.
Nice. Nice.
Number one today is some new rumors about the new Zelda game.
I haven't heard these.
I know. You've heard these?
No, I have not.
Okay, well, this will be interesting for you then.
Yes.
This is slated for release on the Wii U, and it will be available on Nintendo's new system, the NX, is what they're calling it now.
I've heard about this NX, yeah. But I haven't heard a lot about it, but that's like another talking point. Let's keep going with the Zelda.
Well, there's not a lot about it. It's just a lot of smoke and mirrors right now, but it's coming.
Okay.
Anyways, this girl, Emily Rogers, she was the one who also revealed that there's a new Paper Mario coming to the Wii U soon.
Okay, so your source is accurate.
So,
in a way.
You know, and then, so what she's saying about this new Zelda game is that there will be a male or female playable character.
Whoa.
And
like Link and Linkette.
That's right. And all the NPCs will be voice acted.
All of them. I hope there's a lot. I hope that'd be amazing. This will be amazing. Let's sell the game then.
It's incredible to me. Play as a girl, but
yeah,
Is it gonna be Link or like Linkette?
I think it should be Link. Like they don't even have to change the outfit at all.
I hope they don't go lame and just let you play as Zelda.
No, that would be boring. I think
that would suck. We've all done that in Smash Bros.
Right, like Zelda is the princess. Let her just be the princess, you
know? Yeah, Zelda, you do your own thing. We're going to play as Linkette.
Linkette.
That's what we're going to start calling
her. Voice. She could have the same voice actor. Yeah, because it's just such like a young person.
Yeah!
Yeah, exactly.
We're going to dub her Linkette.
Yeah,
so from
that's
now
what they'll
on,
go with,
from
I think.
From now on, that's her name.
That's, I think, like as a design choice, I think that's what they'll pick.
Yeah, probably. But I'm also interested in the voice acting too, which
of every NPC they have interesting NPCs.
I know, and they're probably gonna have some weird voices too.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like,
because you know they've got some weird freaking characters.
Yeah, this will be very interesting to see what they even pick for the voices.
Yeah, it'll be weird.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What was the first rumor again? Like there's the voices and
the male or female character.
Oh yeah, Linkette.
Forgot already.
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
I thought there was three, to be honest, but whatever.
Well, get over it.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. There's only two.
Now, are we done talking about this topic, or do can
I think
move
so.
On, or we can
I am.
We can move on?
Mm-hmm.
You approve? Okay.
I approve.
This next one is about the game Rust. Have you played Rust?
No.
I haven't played Rust either, but it looks like one I'm waiting for to get out of early access before I jump in, but Rust assigns gender to characters based on your Steam ID now.
Yeah, I did hear about this.
So when you enter the game, you're immediately whatever I guess you've listed as your gender in your Steam account.
Yeah.
This comes also after recently, so this is like within the last 2 weeks, they just started randomly assigning race and facial features to your character.
Well, who's to say the gender's not random and just based on like the first letter of your name or whatever?
It could be too. It could be too. I just thought that was funny because they got in a bit of hot water with the race thing. You know, just randomly assigning races, like, you know.
So?
Well, I don't know. Some people, you know, people get offended by anything these days.
Oh, I know.
Oh, I'm not playing as another race. That's just weird. Who cares, man?
Meanwhile, Garrett, every character you have is a girl. That's
every fun. Character I have is a girl. Don't tell everybody. Just
And they're always a different skin color, like purple or green.
They're always weirdly haired too. Like it's, you know, I'm into the foreign stuff. The weird obscure. I like the green hair, black, you know, I don't know, weird colors, man.
Yeah, exactly. But anyway.
Okay, moving on. We're not going to touch that touchy subject.
Yeah, I don't like Rust that much, just from like the community that I've seen has built around it. It might be a fine game, but I don't know. I wouldn't play it a lot.
Well, maybe they're just trying to get in the news. Anyways. This one's pretty interesting as well. So last week, this is a bit of news from last week that's update. We didn't talk about it last week, though. Last week, Blizzard took some minor flack on some forums about this Overwatch character, Tracer. Have you heard about this?
Yeah, just a little bit.
Yeah,
so I try to avoid it because it sounds more like people getting offended over nothing.
Well,
but
it was a little bit of that. People got offended over her pose where she was she was facing away. But her back was showing, and you could see the outline of her butt.
Okay.
And so some people on this forum were like, you know, this character shouldn't be overly sexualized. This butt pose is so, you know, it's wrong for the character. You know, just griping.
Yeah.
But what ended up happening is the Overwatch lead developer, I think, or the head of the Blizzard studio, responded saying, you know, we're going to change it. They got even more flack for that. It's like, oh, bowing down to crit, you know. Anyway, there was huge discussion about it. This week, they actually changed it. So they showed the new one. If you're watching on YouTube, I'll put the two pictures of the before and after pictures up. But if you get a chance to look at this for our other listeners, I didn't notice a big difference. Like, you still see her butt.
Right, like they just don't show it full frontal, I believe. I think I saw the new one only.
Yeah,
and it was like a side or
it was like a
side.
Little bit to the side, but you could still see the outline of her butt. And, you know, honestly, it almost looked a little bit more sexual. I don't know. I just thought, oh, this is so stupid, guys. Just shut up. Like, getting in discussions about this butt, like, it's a video game. And then you change it, and it's, oh, I bet people are going to be like, oh, you didn't change it enough. Oh, it's bad.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like, enough. You know, enough.
I know, like, that's just accept it as a design choice that somebody made, and it's not trying to offend anybody, and move on.
I bet it'll spawn a bunch of, like, fan creations about, like, Tracer being, like, the hot chick Tracer.
Oh, definitely.
Just to make fun of Blizzard.
Hey, that's a theory, like, if it exists, there's porn of it that exists, so.
The Tracer butt pose porno.
Yeah.
Okay, kids, children, adults also, it's time for everybody's favorite segment,
critically acclaimed, worldwide
renowned.
We'll do a segment of this live at the Video Game Awards one year.
Next year, we're going to be there. Everybody be there.
That'll be
great. EA is going to be there too. This is what is EA screwing up this week?
What is EA screwing up this week?
Well, like, if we do this segment every week, I might have to start grasping at straws.
Okay.
But I thought this one was kind of interesting and fit the bill pretty well.
Okay.
So 3 years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, EA had a big court battle with the NCAA over their NCAA video games, right?
Right.
You know, and paying the players for their likeness. Like, that was their license. They could just use these players' bodies and faces and just put a number instead of their name. You know, so they had a lawsuit about it. They settled it outside of court or whatever, I guess. They settled. And then they stopped making the games. So now, this past week, a bunch of former players have been tweeting out pictures and stuff, like notifications that they finally got a check from EA.
Oh, wow.
For this money.
This is just happening now?
That's just happening now. I read this article. It came out today, this article.
That's nuts.
Which is pretty funny.
That's
but anyway,
so long.
It was saying that these checks ranged from $100 to approximately some over $10,000. Depending on how long the player played and I guess how popular they were and whatever. Mm. Which is like, come on, EA. Like, if this is true, you know, it could just be now. It just could be just now. It's people are talking about it now.
Yeah.
But it's like, come on. It took you, what, 3 or 4 years to get these checks out to these people? Like, imagine you're the guy who gets, like, $50. You played for 1 year, and you were the third string kicker on the football team. You never saw the light of day.
He's just living a normal life now and just gets a check from a video game company.
He gets a check from EA for $50.
Yeah.
And he's just like, what the hell is this?
Yeah, what do I do with this?
I mean, he'll probably, you know, buy a 22-4 and go for a rip with the boys, but... No, but they're in the States, so they'll do something else cooler. But, you know, I just thought that was hilarious. EA, come on, get it together.
No, that is actually, like, outrageous. How can that happen? That's like over 2 years for sure, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't know. It must have taken, like, all the legal time and just the drawn out.
Yeah.
Who knows, man?
Definitely.
Pretty
anyway,
funny, though.
I think that's hilarious, though, that it's another thing EA has been in the news about. Like,
well, I predict there'll be one next week, too.
Oh, I think so. I have one kind of in the bank from when I was traveling to Miami recently. But, like, it wouldn't have been what they did last week, but if we needed some filler, I have another week's thing.
Oh, a little little teaser for future episodes.
Mm-hmm. So always be sure to check in to see if I'm talking about that thing that EA screwed up.
Future EA screw-ups.
A couple months ago.
Teased by Josh Taylor this episode.
Future EA screw-ups, exactly.
From one beautiful segment on to another. It's time for our Steam Picks of the Week.
Yeah, I always love Steam Picks of the Week because I don't actually get a lot of time to go through all of Steam. And so when you hit me with a Steam Pick, it's like, okay, a game that someone else has found that I get to like check out now.
I love the Steam Picks because I love to see what weird game that I find I like for some reason that nobody's going to play.
Yeah, fair.
You pick the good ones. I'm like, oh, this looks cool. Nope. Nobody's going to buy it. This one, I think, though, this week I might redeem myself. So
okay,
I'll go first. Bros before hoes.
Okay. Fair. Wait, did you say bros before hoes?
Bros before hoes.
I think the audience would disagree on that one.
I'm a bro.
I think I'm more of a bro.
All right.
We can see, though.
All right,
we'll
bro.
Have to turn to the comments and other such communications for that one.
I'm going to set the bar high on this one.
Okay.
As high. Please. Maybe as high as I've ever gone, but you had a pretty good one with Hyper Light Drifter.
True.
So my Steam pick of the week is Automata Empire.
Okay, man.
Do we have the same one?
No, I saw this, though.
Okay.
But I, yeah.
Yeah, so, okay. The Steam page says, seize power and build an empire of fuzzy cellular automata monsters. Herd hundreds of mindless subjects to smash your rivals' castles and steal their territory in this RTS-inspired Conway's Game of Life.
Oh, wow. I wonder how they do this. Like, I'm looking at the video. What's going on?
You know, it looked kind of stupid to me at first, which you know is right up my alley. I love stupid games.
Right.
But then I saw that there actually looked like when the camera zooms out in their trailer... And it just shows the huge map of all these little things that you're doing. I thought, wow, this actually looks like it could be pretty deep and actually a pretty good strategy game. I might check it out.
Yeah, I think there will be a lot of strategy. As I don't know how like medieval theme-wise it is, but like the mechanics look really interesting for sure.
Yeah, no, I'm definitely down for it. And that's my Steam pick of the week.
That's a good Steam pick of the week, I think. Because like I don't know that I would have looked at this much. How'd
you
not pick
it
as your Steam pick?
See, you shouldn't have sold me so high by saying you look forward to my picks to hear about games you wouldn't look at.
But, well, I don't know. I looked at this, but I didn't look at it for long. But now that we've kind of talked about it a bit.
Look deeper.
Exactly.
Look deep into this game, Josh. Look deep. Automata Empire.
All right.
It's $10. Canadian.
Oh, a, so that's like cheap for you American folks.
Right. And so for a couple hours of solid deep strategy gameplay, way better than Clash of Clans.
Oh,
sorry, did I offend some people out there with that? My bad.
Hey man.
You play COC?
No, I do not.
Good.
Is it my turn? I'm excited to talk about my game. It looks really fun.
All right, hit me with it.
All right. So my pick is a game called Fortify. It says, Fortify is a real-time strategy game with a lower defense or a tower defense twist. Defend your castle from attacking monsters and siege weapons by using ranged and melee defenders, catapults, cannons, oil fields, and more. You start at the Iron Age, advancing to the Medieval Age, and later the Imperial Age.
This is right up your alley, eh, bud?
This is like my ideal sounding game. How well they pulled it off, though, I'm not sure. But it's got like a top-down view and a castle that always seems to be in the middle.
Yeah.
And then there's like UI elements all around the side, but it looks like an RTS game. You're going to spawn units from your castle and defend it from
enemy invaders. Looks like they've tried to mix RTS with like the classic tower defense flash games like that you play on Miniclip or whatever.
Exactly. And you get to like upgrade your castle through the ages, which no doubt gives you better access to better units and stuff. It just makes probably combat more exciting.
And it's on sale, 15% off. Look at that.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to buy this right now. $4.66.
Buy it. Buy it now.
I'm going to play it on our break.
Great. Glad to see you'll be preparing for the show. $4.66 Canadian. That's about
really cheap.
That's about
sale.
10 cents American.
Is it?
Close. Maybe 15.
Sounds about right to me, though.
Yeah, this game definitely seems right up your alley, Josh. Like, you almost like the games with terrible graphics. The worse a game's graphics, it's like the more you like it.
I don't know about the worse a game's graphics, because I'm definitely a fan of graphics. Like, don't get me wrong.
I'm just kidding.
Yeah, good.
I'm just kidding, bud. Just a reminder that Video Games Day is brought to you by Yes Guy Gaming. Check out Yes Guy Gaming's website or YouTube channel for video game reviews as well as every episode, every single one of Video Games, eh? So head over there, like, subscribe, share, do all that great stuff. We definitely appreciate any and all support here on Video Games, eh? And on that note, let's get back to the show. Josh, what have you been playing this week?
Okay, Garrett, so this week I've been playing just a lot more Diablo 3, to be honest.
That's it?
Yeah, but I played at the beginning of the week, like right after our last episode, I played some Hitman. So that was technically part of this week.
Well, so we've talked about both of those games. You got any updates?
Not really, man. Hitman is still fun. Like, I was just replaying it now. Like, this is now officially replay value on the first episode.
And how long have you played? I'm interested to see. Like, how many hours have you put into that game so far?
Let me see. I'm now up to 6.
Well, that's pretty good.
Yeah, like, considering it's only a part of a completed game, right?
Would you play
a
more?
A single mission.
Would you play more?
Yeah, I actually have been quite busy this week, so yeah, I would play more if I had time.
Wow, so that's you're going to probably land right in our 7 to 10 estimate for that game.
Oh, I think so.
Which
at that price,
I think that's pretty good.
Right?
Well, that's good to hear.
Yeah, and Diablo 3, I've gotten my money's worth, no doubt. I've played I don't know how to check the number of hours on the Battle.net client.
Yeah.
But I've played some considerable amount.
I'd believe it. I bet it's upward of 300 hours.
Total, maybe, but yeah.
Total, yeah. That's a lot, man.
Yeah, I wonder how to figure that out. Anyway.
Wow, whatever.
That's all I've been playing. Diablo's mechanics are still good. They're still crisp.
Okay.
I'm just stronger now and doing harder things. It's fun.
Well, it's glad to see that the more you play a game, the better you get at it.
Yeah.
Because if it weren't that way for you, I might have to suggest you just quit altogether.
Yeah, as it should be, though.
If you're terrible, quit. No, that's a terrible message.
Right. If you're a kid listening, do the opposite of what we say.
If you're terrible, practice. If your mom says stop, keep playing. That's what I did, and look where I ended up. Pretty good, right?
Pretty good. What about you, Garrett? What have you been playing this week?
I've been playing a lot. More than
I'd like to hear that.
More than I have any of the weeks we've done an episode.
No, okay then.
In the past 5 weeks we've done, I've been playing one game only.
What game?
And I've been playing a ton of hours.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
20-plus hours in this game. I've been playing Stardew Valley.
Dun-dun-dun-dun.
I went back to Stardew Valley, and I am so glad that I did.
You love it now, eh?
I love it. I'm just giddy thinking about it. Like, it just evokes such a nostalgic, exciting feel. I'm smiling. Look at me. I'm just...
That Harvest Moon feel, man, when you can build and run your own farm and marry a girl and who knows what
I
else.
I just got married. Before filming this episode, I just got married.
Nice.
Guess who I married? Guess.
I have no idea, man. It's been a while since I've played, so I don't actually remember the character names. But, yeah, I have no idea. Who'd you marry?
Haley, the blonde chick.
Nice, dude. That's a great marry.
Well, we'll see how it plays out. I don't know. First day, yeah. I gotta say, we got married. Well, it's a bit weird. You get married, and then you start the day at 6 a.m. So it's like you got married at 5 a.m. and then took an hour, and you're like, all right, let's go back to the farm, do our work.
It doesn't skip an entire day for your wedding?
No.
Okay.
Which is good. Whatever. I didn't mind it. I didn't mind it, but it was funny. So we woke up on our first day of being married, and she'd fed the animals and the dog.
Nice, and we all know what she did the night before. Well, the night of your marriage.
I don't know if I did or not. I don't know. True. I can't tell. I guess we'll find out in 9 months.
Wait, did you make a male character for Stardew Valley?
Yeah, I made a male character. I made the guy look like me.
That's right. That's right. He does a little bit.
Yeah.
A lot.
Spiky hair, full beard. Obviously,
full beard.
Looks exactly like me.
It's the same guy.
Like I'm sometimes looking at the screen and I think I'm maybe looking in the mirror.
Right, especially with its like pixel art and like isometric perspective. That's how your mirror is.
That's how I see myself, though. Like that's I look in the mirror and I see a pixelated me
from the top.
I'm just kidding. We kid. But what I'm not kidding about is how much I love this game. And you know what? It might have been one that passed me by, but what I convinced myself to go back to it because I was like, okay. Is this game going to be considered for Game of the Year?
I think some places might.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
Could it be? Is it going to be in the conversation? Well, I don't mean Game of the Year. I mean, is it going to be in the top 10?
Right. Yeah. Is it going to be pick? Like, are people still going to talk about this game?
And I'm going, well, yeah, it might very well be. And at that point, I was like, okay, I got to play it. I got to review it. So I'm pulling out all the stops for this one. I want to play as much as I can, get every little nook and cranny of the game, really feel it and love it, but so I can give a good verdict and, an accurate review. I want to do the best review possible for this game just because I'm so passionate about it.
Yeah.
And one guy made it. I didn't know that. I'll be honest. When we were talking about it, episode one, this is 5 weeks ago. I didn't know one guy made it.
Yeah, the whole game is made by one guy. Art, programming, all of it, one guy.
It's pretty incredible that guy did that. And he did it, like, he did Harvest Moon way better. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Like, there's more. It is nice. It runs well. Like, it feels nice when you do actions. All the sounds are really nice. The art.
It's great.
Like, it's so good, man. What do you love about it? What's your favorite thing to do?
Well... So my favorite thing is building. I like to build stuff. So, like, I feel like I cheated every time I look up on the internet what the best thing to do is.
Right. See, that feels like cheating, but at the same time, it's...
I mean, I gotta know. I'm gonna figure it out soon enough anyways, but... So in the summer and fall, the berries, like the blueberries and the raspberries...
Yeah.
...are just, like, you just rake in the dough. Like in Harvest Moon, the old Harvest Moons, you'd have a great day and you'd get 6,000 gold.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like, okay, yeah, great day, 6,000 gold. Now I can buy one cow. You know, like here, you have a great day. I set up 90 blueberries.
Yeah.
And all in one day, I harvested them.
How much
20
money
grand.
That?
20 grand. Yeah. One day. Boom. There's
so
20
what
grand.
Can you buy What can you buy with 20 grand?
Well, so 20 grand, I bought a barn and 4 cows.
Holy mackerel, man. Yeah, that's about right,
Which
though.
Is like,
holy crap.
Right on.
Feels good, though, right? Feels good.
Feels good.
And
great.
It also, it feels good knowing that there's like a lot more you can buy. You have a lot more days like that.
Yeah. Well, because they regrow. So yeah. Once they mature, every 4 days, you get 20 grand.
Yep. Boom, boom,
so
boom.
So I bought a lot of stuff. So I got a big barn. I'm going to buy some goats. Oh, I went on a spree because I have so much money, I don't know what to do with it.
Yeah.
So I'm having a lot of fun with the game, and I want to go back and, you know, I want to see what my kid looks like. I don't know what, you know, I want to have a kid. I wonder if there's multiple kids. Like, I don't want to spoil it for myself. I just want to see what the game has to offer because I'm enjoying it so much.
Yeah.
I do.
Wow, that's good.
There are, like, just a couple slight problems.
Okay. Let's go over some of those.
That I think are maybe just drawbacks of the genre.
Okay.
I'm not sure how they would be fixed. You know, a couple things with the geography of the map really pissed me off.
Okay, yeah.
Right? Like, where everything is located. I'm just like, this is so stupid.
Like, it's all like, it feels like everything's sort of tough to get to.
Right. And like, so the immediately when you walk to the right out of your farm, there's that long stretch of path that you got to walk across to get to the town.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, I mean, I get maybe my farm is outside the town a little bit, but that.
Man, I heard.
Yeah.
Go on. No, go on.
No, you go.
No, I'll go. There you go.
Anyway, that stretch of path is useless to me. Other than the car, right? I noticed the thing. You fix that, you go to the desert. I see that. But
you've got the desert, right?
I haven't.
Like, you haven't been there?
No, I haven't finished a year.
No, for me it happened, I think, on the first day of summer. I think it's kind of random around summer
really?
For you. Yeah.
How?
I don't want to spoil too much.
Well, how do you get it?
Do you mind? Here, put a big spoiler alert right now on the everything.
How does it unlock?
Spoiler alert. You get an earthquake happens.
And then what?
And then, like, some rocks at the top of that, like, where the bus is, like, erode away, I believe. And then you can go up to the desert. And in the desert, there's, like, a bathhouse where if you go in the baths, you heal. Your energy heals for free.
So I could have been doing that the whole time?
No, because I don't. You have to wait for the earthquake.
The earthquake happened.
Oh, then, yeah, you can go right up to the desert.
And I miss. See, how would I? Again. Like, that's the other thing. There's a couple of minor things that just are a little bit confusing, and I there must be a reason for them.
Mm-hmm.
Like that earthquake. I woke up the earthquake, and I looked around my farm. I was like, oh, crap. Are my crops gone? Are my blueberries messed?
Right, like nothing happened.
Nothing happened.
To you.
To me.
Yeah.
So I was like, all right, I'm good. Forgot about it. Like, I didn't know what that was for.
Yeah, for me, same thing. I didn't know what happened, but I gave it to Google right away.
See, yeah, I could do the most best way to make money, crops, like what artisan goods you can make and craft and all that stuff, get right into that. And I just didn't want to because I want to play it fresh, just like go through like I would go through a Harvest Moon game.
Right, like back in the olden days, that good feel.
And I'm thankful that I did because I feel better discovering these things on my own. I mean, the blueberries and raspberries things, you got to know that. If you're playing this game, you gotta have a shitload of blueberries and a buttload of raspberries in summer and fall. You're gonna make a crap load of money. You have to do that.
Yeah.
You know, but everything else, I feel good finding out on my own, like how to make cheese. Like you get the cheesemaker.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, make cheese out of my cow's milk. That's great.
Hmm.
I love it.
Yeah.
But yeah, geographically running around, it's just like I'm so far away from certain things and so close to others.
Right, but part of that is like in the balance. It like to get to the mine you have to go quite a bit, which like takes up some of your time of day.
No, that makes sense. So the mine is it takes X amount of time to get there regardless of which route you take. But if you're trying to get to the carpenters.
Where's that? Oh yeah, that's like over to town and up, right?
Well, but if you just go straight north from your farm, there's a shortcut that takes you right there.
Right.
It's like, what is the point of this? If I'm in town, now the carpenters is way out of my way, where I'm almost as fast to go right back to my farm than up. It just seemed a bit weird that was there.
Hmm. Yeah, I get that.
Or to get to the, you know, just weird little things like that. But and what I was so impressed with, this is what I was gonna say, is that I went and checked out the Reddit community for this game. And this developer,
He's active.
He's active on there discussing you know, the patch updates and stuff like that.
Yep.
Right?
He's very on the internet and stuff.
And I just immediately, I was like, wow, this is a special person.
Yeah.
They make a great game, and they don't
like he
just...
He loves his own game, you know, and that's good.
It's a labor of love for this guy. And I greatly appreciate that. And if I ever meet him, I'm going to give him a firm handshake and say, you know what, man? Keep doing what you're doing. I hope there's a Stardew Valley 2 or he does something else along this vein. I'm sure he maybe wants to branch out after this, but he does it so well. Like, and Harvest Moon is so stupid for not going this direction with it.
Where you can have more things to do, basically.
Because this guy has taken it.
Yeah.
He just worked hard and took it. He exactly. took Harvest Moon. Now, Harvest what? Who cares? Like, no, that's a kid's game. That's a weird kid's game.
Yeah.
But kids would play Stardew Valley.
Yeah, for sure.
They still could. It's the same. So I have the utmost respect for this guy. And the game.
Man, there's so much to do, like.
And that'll reflect in my score on the review at the end.
Yeah, cool. I'm excited for the review then. Where's that going to be again?
It's on yesguygaming.com. Well, if you're watching us on YouTube, you know where my reviews are. But if you're listening to us on iTunes,
right,
iTunes is actually really the only way to listen to us that you wouldn't know how to find yesguygaming.com. But here's how you do it.
Yeah.
Go into that search bar at the top of your, you know, search thing on your computer. Type in yesguygaming.com. It'll take you right there.
Nice. What else? So that's all you've been playing then, no doubt.
That's it. I've been hardcore Stardew Valley. I'm addicted.
Well, that's good. Did I mention that might happen? Maybe? I don't know. It's a good game.
Dude, I was wrong.
Yeah.
What I said in episode 1. You guys can go look
back. Good thing
you
didn't review it back then.
Well, no. If I had played it.
True, yeah.
For any longer than 15 minutes, I would have known that it's a great game. If I had given it the time that it needs... To settle, then now I'm in the middle of it. I'm loving it. Back then, I was so wrong. I think my words were exactly, it's like Harvest Moon, but different.
Exactly.
And I don't know what I was thinking. It's better than Harvest Moon. It's Harvest Moon, better.
It's so well made and well polished and things feel good and all that.
Yeah, like what he's done way better... is the crops.
Mm.
Because the crops in those old games used to be such a chore. Now, I can do those around 100 crops with my basic watering can. Haven't even upgraded it yet. And that takes...
Yeah.
It takes like no time at all. Not no time. You still have to go through
but
it.
Like,
but it's like, I'm going to do this? Just shorten the time. Like, make it feel like I have to do something. But don't make me waste my entire life just watering
these
crops.
Day. Yeah. No real day.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know. And, okay, Stardew Valley, what it does, I think, really well, is every time a day ends, you're like, I can just play one more day. Like, I'll just play one more day.
Because you have to play one more day because there's no other way to save.
Right. And, like, so you'll save and you'll be like, okay, I got time for one more day. And then you'll finish that day and you'll say, that day's only like 5 minutes. I got another time for another day.
Yeah. You can play for hours.
And... Yeah, and it like saves, and then you see how much money you get like right away from the previous day. It's like,
oh,
I guess I should go today to buy that thing and do this thing. And it's like, oh, fuck.
And that's one thing Harvest Moon never did either.
Yeah.
Like, they had games on the Wii. Like, the Wii had the power of that console. This guy just makes a basic pixel art game on the PC and just says, you know what, I'm going to do it well.
I know. They went for that 3D graphics
and
stuff.
This makes so much sense. And this is a great sign. Great sign. Because here's a guy took a franchise that he loves. Mm-hmm. I assume he loves it. Because he did such good care with the genre. He took such care. So he must love it. But he took something he loves. Mm-hmm. And he made a good game. There are a lot of good games out there. But he made a good game. And he did well. It sold. He made money.
Yeah, he's pretty happy with how that went,
like,
I think.
Like
really happy.
Because I'm sure there are times people make great games, they just don't get the exposure, and then, you know, it's frustrating. You know,
yep.
a game like that I can maybe think of, for example, is a game like the Divinity series, all of them.
Right. What do you mean?
I watched some videos of that guy, the lead of that Larian Studios who does those games.
Yeah.
And they have like four or five games in that series. Did you know that?
No.
Right.
I knew they had one before, at least one. I didn't know how many it was.
Well, it's a series. They have a couple of games. But
Right.
they've just struggled. But Divinity Original Sin is an amazing game.
Yeah,
But
it is. There's so much to do in that as well.
So is Divinity Dragon Commander. It's a pretty good game too. You know, and I'm sure one that they loved, and they loved their own license, and they did it well, but just didn't quite get the traction that Stardew Valley did. I hope other people can see this and go, I want that, and go and get it. Because it benefits everyone. Players love playing these games. I could play this Stardew Valley, and I don't say this a lot. I could play this for hours.
I know, like a lot of hours.
Like, you play a lot of hours of video games. I gotta pick mine carefully. I could play this for hours.
Yeah, but how? Like, it's so good.
It's so good. It's gonna be a tough grade too, though.
True, because it's not perfect. There are flaws, but it's really good.
Right, but how much are those flaws take away?
Right.
You know, I don't know. It's going to be interesting. We'll see where I end up. I might have another 20 hours left in the game, though, before that. But that could take me another 3 weeks to get in. I don't know.
Who knows?
Jinx.
So no guarantee on when you're releasing that review.
Definitely no guarantee. It wasn't like Hyper Light Drifter where I was in and out, review, knew it. And I still stand by that, even after I've heard the feedback.
Yeah, it's hard, eh?
No, I've had a couple people reach out on our YouTube channel and comment saying that, you know, they agree. Some of them felt that I was maybe a bit harsh with the grade, but still agreed with the points I made. And it's like, okay, well, that's what it is, right? That's what reviewing is. Here's the points.
Yeah.
Here's the points. And then the subjective part of it, how much does it matter to me?
Right.
And that's it, right? So as long as you get the points right, then you add your own subjective thing in. So, no, that was good. But this Stardew, I got a lot more time to spend with this game. I gotta have a son. Yikes. Gotta have a son. Gotta see how long this guy programmed your kid's growth in. Because that was one thing.
Doesn't the mystery of.
Mystery of what?
Like the guy in the White Tower, or the Wizard Tower, sorry. Like, doesn't that entice you at all as well? You gotta figure out what that's all about and what the mine is all about.
Only
like,
a little bit.
So much to do, man.
I know. And then maybe that's why part of its success has come, because, like, there are guys who, I'm sure, well, guys and girls, sorry. There'll be people who will play, they would just mine. They just love the mining and the combat, and they'll really absorb into that. That'll be their main focus because they love it. Because it in itself is like a basic dungeon crawler.
Yeah, exactly. Like, it's pretty fun.
You know,
just doing that.
Like, and that's something that I rarely do.
Yeah.
I rarely go mining. I only go in there to get the stuff that I absolutely need because I'm just so absorbed with everything else.
Exactly. Like, there's so much you can do, man.
How many years did you go through?
I forget now.
Did you go through at least one?
Yeah, I think so. I think I said I was at one or two. It's been a while.
And
I forget games.
And you didn't get married, eh?
No, I just did farming.
See, I'm like at fall 9, and I'm already married.
Yeah.
I like took the fastest route to marriage possible.
Yeah. That's nuts.
Yeah.
But still.
Yeah, man. I'm fired up. Well, anything else you want to talk about, Josh? You want to add a new segment to the show?
Well, not a new segment, but actually I did want to mention that we were talking about Yooka-Laylee last week, which is supposed to be a 3D platformer in the vein of Banjo-Kazooie, obviously.
We were talking about that.
Yeah, and I was thinking about like 3D platforms, and then I saw that Ratchet & Clank came out like right around right now when we're releasing this podcast.
Yeah, yeah, Ratchet and Clank. No, I saw that too.
And I see that like the top link on Reddit for games is the Ratchet and Clank review from IGN, and they gave it a 9 out of 10, which tells me that
really?
This is probably a really fun like kind of old schoolish 3D platformer, but in a very modern way.
See, I think GameSpot's was a 7.
Oh, that's different.
I gotta look that up now, though. But I'll look that up as we speak. But Ratchet yeah,
Clank, like
sure.
It looks really cool, man. Like I'm looking at footage right now. It's like I've never played any Ratchet and Clank games, but holy, does it look kind of fun? If you have time. Yeah.
Oh no, they gave it an 8.
Okay, still that's a good mark, good grade.
Yeah, so that one might be one I check out as well. Gosh, I'm already behind. This is not good. See, this is the problem being a reviewer. You're playing one game, you're loving it, but there's another you want to play and review, but if you're too late to get to it,
you know,
people don't really care as much.
Exactly.
Are you going to play that?
I don't know. I have no idea.
There's a Ratchet and Clank movie coming out. You knew that, eh?
No. I had no idea about
that. Yeah, they're making a movie of that game.
That's nuts.
And it's supposed to be, I don't know, the hype is there. I'm going to look that up, make sure I didn't. I'm popping off.
Yeah, if they're releasing a game right now and they're working on a movie.
No, it's weird.
It's big. Also, there's a game I'm really excited about. The Banner Saga comes out next week.
The Banner Saga 2.
Yes, but they just released 33 minutes of gameplay for that today.
Oh, is it the same as the first one?
It looks almost identical, yeah. But like new art, which is all great, because that's why I love this game. The art and the story.
Yeah.
Honestly, the mechanics were fine. Apparently, they've like upgraded the combat a little bit, and the storytelling has more like consequences for your decisions. Right. But holy, that's all I really wanted from this game, because I just love the story and stuff, the art, everything.
Yeah, like you love your crew. It's Vikings, right?
Yeah, like you have clansmen, Vikings, and like they're called Varl.
Yeah, so, and you're just kind of going through the mountains or whatever.
Yeah, and you're like the world is crumbling around you, and like. There's the robotic guys as your enemies. It's nuts.
Yeah, again, this game, the Banner Saga was one that I heard a lot of good things about when the first one came out.
Did you ever play it?
No, I never played it. And it's one that I was interested in and wanted to play, but it came out, like it was out and relevant around a time where there were a lot of other major games that I was playing at the time, I think, and doing reviews for. And it just, again, it's one that kind of slipped through. So,
yeah. Know,
Banner Saga 2, I'm already behind. Like, I haven't played the first one.
Man, you got to play the first one, and then you got to play the second one.
How long does the first one take to beat?
Okay, so the first one, and these games are very story based. So, like, I played it once, and I've literally never fired it up again.
Right.
But the first one took me 13 hours.
Okay, see that 13 hours is a tough fit in with my other 30 hours that I'm devoting to Stardew Valley.
But in the game, in the first one, you can skip a lot of the combat just by, like, it's an option. You don't have to do it as much.
So
yeah.
I could just watch the story?
Basically, and make the decisions. But, like, the decisions you make sometimes can avoid a lot of combat. Like, I would take pretty much any combat opportunity.
Right.
But, yeah.
Well, because you just like to fight.
Well, like, the fighting, for me, I don't normally like turn-based games at all. Like, I don't like XCOM.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. I just never really been my type of game.
Oh.
Well, like, Civilization is different. Like, I love Civ.
Oh, turn-based.
I don't necessarily... Yeah, I know. I don't like the combat, the third-person turn-based combat, I guess. And this has it, but I loved it. It was simple and yet deep and fun yet hard and whatever. It was perfect for me, difficulty-wise.
Yeah,
and the story was, like, all-engrossing. I wanted to proceed with the story always.
Yeah, so that one does look beautiful.
Yeah,
and I think that's what they go for. It's funny how it's funny how these trends kind of come and go in video games, eh? And just the way, you know, in video games, eh? These trends in these video games, eh? You know, these certain releases coming out at the same time, eh? Like all these games trying to have this cartoony style art feel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's been a lot of them lately. You know, it seems to be a bit of a trend, and hey, I'm not complaining. But you know, the other thing too, I look through the Steam thing, looking for these Steam picks of the week. So many point and click adventures.
Okay, I don't. Nah, yeah, I'm not a fan of those personally.
So,
but
so
I get
many.
They're like, they have a genre. They're a niche or whatever.
Yeah.
There's so many.
But there's so many of them. Like, I'm not gonna play all these point and click adventures. No, sorry.
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry, I'm not gonna point and click.
another gameplay video that came out also today. is No Man's Sky. Have you heard of No Man's
Right.
Sky?
Yes. Who? Well, yes, I
Yeah,
have.
who hasn't at this point?
Well, I mean, it's. I'll be honest. It's a bit of an obscure one, just because it's like a new developer. It's not like one of the major developers. New
Right, but it is
IP. Like it,
very
you know,
hyped.
it's very out there, very hyped. I agree. I've heard about it, and I'm looking so forward to it.
Yeah, and so there's 21 minutes of new gameplay out, which it's he like the developer Sean Murray guy there is there, and he says it's just like a regular. This is what 20 minutes might be like, but I feel like it's rigged. Like he just is perfectly flowing through actions and things that you can do in the game. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so I watched a bit of that video too.
Okay.
And it looks real fun.
But yeah, don't get me wrong. All the things you can
But
do, whether
I
they're.
agree with you though. Like it looks like it could be a little bit slow
Yeah, like
at
I
times.
don't think my gaming experience will be quite as rapid fire as his is.
Yeah.
Like mine will take me. I'll be on a planet with no life probably for like 35 minutes or more.
Yeah.
Just trying to run somewhere.
Just trying to
But
figure out how to
that's
get the
fine,
hell
man.
out of there.
And then when he went to the, I don't know if you got this far, but when he goes to the galaxy map and like shows you how big it is, how long it's going to take you to get to the center of the galaxy, it's like, oh man,
Yeah, man.
he's
Like,
right.
oh, wow. It's daunting for sure. But no, I look it that's the one thing that it's like excites me about this game, 'cause it's like, okay, first person shooter,
Yep.
you know, new creatures, interesting creatures, good, both positive, you know.
Yeah, all positive.
Whatever, like it is what it is. But the one thing that was really special to me about this game is that galaxy. Is the hugeness of it
I know.
that I'm super
It's
excited for,
massive.
because you know that's something that as gamers we're all looking for, I think, at some level, because we always
Yeah.
get these cookie cutter experiences where we all experience the same thing, you know, in these linear stories or even these non-linear stories, but we're all experiencing these same kind of events, which is great because we can all share them. But we also all want to have a unique, you know, something unique to us as players.
Exactly. We want to be able to share unique experiences with people.
That's
Like,
right.
yeah.
And
So that's going to be nuts.
I think that's going to be something that's going to be really prevalent in this game, and that they're going to do really well, you know, just because that's what it looks like. But again, it does look to me like it could be a bit slow to get to. Like, I watched the first bit
Yeah.
where he's like identifying all these creatures, and that gets you money.
Right.
You know, and so how many creatures do you have to identify before you get enough money to buy something?
Exactly.
Like, it might have to be a fair amount, but is identifying creatures really that fun?
Right.
You know,
Or do
at
you want
some
to like
level.
shoot these creatures and
Yeah.
hunt them or whatever,
You know,
right?
at some level it's fun, I'm sure, finding new and rare ones, but rare ones are rare. What's the bulk of your experience going to be taken up doing?
Exactly.
You know, mining resources and finding these basic animals?
See
Maybe,
that
maybe.
they advertise that there's like NPCs and like a language, all these languages you have to learn, and like there's just lots going on you have to learn and
Did
do.
they show any of that?
He shows like he learns a word of a language or something.
One word.
I think it's the word traveler, I think.
Weird.
Yeah.
So
But
you gotta learn all million words in each of these languages, or?
well, that's what I mean. Like, does it just eventually say, okay, you've learned like 100 words or 10 words, now you know them all? Or
It's so intriguing. And you know what? And they do it on purpose. Like, it's hard to say this is gonna be a normal 20 minutes in the game when, like, okay, you did everything in the game and all this cool stuff came up.
Yeah.
I don't know. It is pretty cool, though.
I know.
It does look
I'm
pretty
excited
cool.
for it.
I'm
I'm
super excited
definitely
for it.
excited for it, but I'm not gonna pre-order it because I'm nervous
No.
about my money.
No, I'll never pre-order a game again.
Yeah.
Even a game like this where I know for a fact that I'm going to buy it.
Like, yeah, exactly. I know I'm gonna probably buy it regardless of what goes on.
I know, but like, how often do they sell out on day one anymore? Because all the other people who are pre-ordering, they get their copies, and then there's just the X amount of copies they have in the store.
Yeah. Well, what are you getting it on? I'm getting it for PC, so mine's also digital downloads.
See, I'll probably get
I
it
can
for
never run out.
PS4.
Okay, yeah. And with like a disc.
Yeah,
Okay,
I
yeah.
would rather play it on PS4, just because I want to. I don't know. I want to see what that's like. I'm a bit more of a console gamer just at heart. Like
Okay.
I play Stardew Valley with a gamepad,
Right, like there's something to be said about sitting on a couch playing a video
game. That's right,
game.
And that, yeah. that you know that's where I feel a little bit more at home. So I think that's where I'm going to play it. But but yeah, you'll have to tell me how they differ. I wonder if there's cross-platform play. Like if we can, play a meetup. Like I heard an interview with this guy, and he says, well, it'll take a while for you to run into any other players.
Right, like because apparently it's just so massive.
I'm like, okay, that's cool on one level. Like, I'm going to be having my own unique experience. But on another level, am I going to be able to play with my friends?
Like, there should be, like, the option to, like, temporarily jump over to your friend's world or whatever.
Well, or just be there with your friend. Like, going true, on a co-op adventure like this. Like, I don't know. Like, if say you and I are playing the game, and we got to try to coordinate where we are in this huge galaxy and to find each other. And, like, say we start... At two complete ends of the galaxy. Like, complete opposite.
Yeah, we could be at opposite ends.
Like, we're the middle of the universe is between us. Like, imagine that. We've got to go, you know. So, like, what are we going to do then? Start a new game until we're close enough that we can reach each other? And how will you know to reach each other? Oh, so many questions. I'm down, though. I'm so down.
I'm down.
I'm so we'll get it going. Down.
That'll be a fun week, man. We'll both have played No Man's Sky. We'll get to talk about all the new stuff we found.
Well, we're gonna
That'll be a good podcast.
If this game is as good as it looks, this might be a couple weeks of No Man's Sky.
Oh yeah.
And you know what? I would bet that'll be the same for pretty much every other major outlet out there.
Yeah, everyone on the internet.
Like the hype for this game is high.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like you can feel the difference in hype. There's like fan hype. There's like these fans are really psyched for this game and generating the hype. So, you know, hard to think of an example right now. You know, but then there's like the media hype where the media is covering a specific game and seemingly for no reason. Like, why are you covering this game instead of another? But the media has just latched onto it. They just love this game. I think No Man's Sky has both.
I agree.
But yeah, the media is just latched onto this game huge, and they're just riding it. Like, No Man's Sky updates constantly. People just want to hear about this game.
I know, man. And every time I see a No Man's Sky update, I get excited. I'm like, oh, good news, hopefully.
Oh, it's good news again. This week, and the update is good again.
Yeah, and like the release date isn't until June or July. And the footage he was showing looked like it was working for the most part. So it's got to be, like, there's better not be a delay. You know what I mean?
Yeah, true. There shouldn't be a delay if the guy's showing off gameplay at this point.
Yeah.
Well, and they'll probably show something off at E3 as well.
When's E3?
E3's around the release date, too.
Oh, I don't know. Would they still show it? I guess they would still show it, but it wouldn't be, like,
I think the guy said it in that video.
Oh, yeah. Did he? I thought he was talking about a previous E3.
We'll be at E3 or something. It sounded like, well, maybe not. It sounded like what he said.
Could be wrong, yeah.
I'm definitely going to try to go to E3 this year.
Yeah?
Yeah, man.
That'd be so sick.
We got to represent video games, eh? Down there in L.A., eh?
I would love to come to that.
Video games L.A., eh?
L.A., get the t-shirts made right now.
They've already sold out.
That's funny.
Yeah. No, that's great.
All right. That's all I had to talk about, I think. I'm going to actually play Fortify after this podcast, by the way.
And that's all I had to talk about, Josh.
Nice. Nice.
So are you saying you're done with me?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Well, I'm done with you.
That's offensive.
I think we should take a break for a week.
Another break. Oh, for a week.
I think we should
take... A week-long break? We're basically breaking up.
I think we should break up for a week.
Okay.
And see other podcasts.
We'll see other podcasts
then. No, I'm just kidding. We can't... No. No, I'm just kidding. I want you back, Josh.
Don't worry, Garrett. I'll never leave.
That's good. That's good to hear. Don't you ever leave me. But seriously, it's time for us to go.
Alrighty.
I want to thank you guys for watching. Again, if you stuck all the way through, you're the real hero. We thank you so much. Our views, just if you want to get the update, our views this last week have literally doubled. In 8 days, which is incredible. So we hope to continue that growth going forward. And it's all thanks to you guys, you know, the ones who stick and watch the whole video. The more you watch, the greater this channel does. So thank you so much.
You've made it this far. Thank you very much.
Yes, definitely to you. The people we thank at the beginning, we'll thank them, but it's you who we want to thank the most.
Exactly.
Josh, I've got to thank you for being here.
Thank you very much for having me, Garrett. Always a pleasure. We should do this again sometime.
We definitely will do this again sometimes because we always seem to do it.
We always do, Garrett.
We always do. So, that's it for Video Games A, and we'll see you guys next time.